Tonight, I want to take you somewhere. A place you pass by every day without a second thought. But what happens when night falls, and it's just you, and it, in the stillness of 2 a.m.? Picture this. A quiet bus stop. The one at the edge of town, where the streetlights flicker and the trees seem to lean in just a little too close. It's the kind of place where time seems to stand still. No cars. No people. Just you, waiting. But, waiting for what? You glance at the schedule. The last bus was supposed to arrive at 1:30 a.m. Is it running late? Not really. It's you who's off schedule. You're sure of it. But the clock on your phone says otherwise. It's 2:03 a.m. and the bus is still scheduled. You feel a chill, but it's not from the cold. The air is heavy, thick with something you can't quite place. Suddenly, a faint whisper rides on the breeze, and when you look at the opposite stop, there's nothing, no one. Just the empty bench, the cracked pavement, and the hollow hum of the streetlight above. You tell yourself it's just your imagination. But the shadow, it moves, doesn't it? Just out of the corner of your eye. It's darker than it should be, longer. It stretches towards you, inch by inch. You blink, and it's gone, but the unease lingers. Then, you hear it. The distant rumble of a bus engine. Relief washes over you, as the sound steadily draws nearer. The bus is right around the corner, almost within reach. The bus has finally arrived. It looks normal at first glance, dusty, worn, just like any other. But as it pulls up, you notice that the windows are clear, yet there's no sign of life within. No driver. No passengers. Just an empty, brightly lit bus with its door hissing open, waiting for you to board. Another whisper, this time from the bus, calls your name, beckoning you to step inside, to take a seat, to let the bus carry you, somewhere. But where? And why does it feel like, once you get on, you'll never get off? The clock on your phone blinks again. It's 2:04 a.m. and the bus is still waiting. Still calling. You take a step back, and the whisper at the bus stop turns into a growl. The shadow around you draws closer, its presence almost tangible. You can feel its breath on your neck, cold and clammy. You have a choice to make. Do you board the bus, knowing you might never return? Or do you stay at the stop, in the dark, with the shadow and its whisper? It's 2:05 a.m. The bus won't wait much longer. What will you do?